In Scratch, we can store things like teams or scores in lists. But using two lists is not ideal. Is there a better way? In Python, there is. It's called a dictionary. Here we have our league table from the previous videos. We have the teams and the scores, and they're in lists inside Scratch here. But we've got two ways of storing the data. We've got the list of teams and the list of scores, but they're not really together. Is there a way we can have them together? The answer is yes, we can in a dictionary. In a dictionary, we have a key and a value. So the key would be the football team, the name of the team, and the value will be their score. So what is a dictionary? Well, a dictionary is a pair of keys and values. So for example, we might have a key in a form. So for example, we have to and from, such as in emails. Who's the email to and who's the email from? Now the value will be the person of who the email is to and the from who the email is from. So we have the key is the label of the field, and the value is what we would put in that field. So another example might be a form. We might have the keys of surname and first name, account number, age, gender, score, things like the labels that we would see on a form. And the values is what we would enter inside the form details. So surname Smith, first name John, account number, age 21. So in our example with the table, we would have the key would be the team name and the value would be the points. So in our challenge, we coded everything in two lists. So now, could we do that using a dictionary? Yes, we can. So let's start with something simple. So we split the problem up before into create table, get match result, calculate match points, update table. And then after that, we run an algorithm to sort the table. So today in this video, we're going to look at the simple parts of that, create table and update table, so we can introduce a dictionary. Then afterwards, we'll look at get match result and calculate match points. But let's start off with create table. So if we look at our Scratch, we started off by inserting the teams in the correct place in the list, and then the scores in the correct place in the other list. So what would we do with a dictionary? Well, instead of having two, we've got one. So we start off by creating an empty dictionary. So here we have a dictionary called league, and we can create that empty dictionary by saying league equals dictionary, D-I-C-T for short, and round brackets. So that will create an empty dictionary. Or we can use these curly brackets. So if they're empty, that would create an empty list. Now we need to add the values inside dictionary. So inside the dictionary called league, we have the key, which would be the football team. So in this example, Liverpool, and value would be their points. So let's say 24. So we can do that with all of the teams. So in our example, we had six teams. So here we have the dictionary league. We have each team as the key, and also we have the points as the value. So that will create our dictionary with the six teams. As a reminder, if you're enjoying this video, please give us a like and also leave a comment if you feel you want to ask any questions. Now, let's have a look at the Python code. We'll create the table, and also at the end, we'll look at how we're going to sort the table an easy way. So just to show you the code in Python before we get to update table. We're going to start off in Python looking at creating the table. So we're going to use a dictionary. So we used a function before called createTable, so we'll do that again. We're going to use a dictionary called league. So first of all, we create the empty dictionary. So league equals dict brackets dictionary. And now we want to add the teams and the scores inside the dictionary. So for example, we could have Liverpool and they had 24 points. If we print that, you can see that our dictionary will have Liverpool and 24. So we can see that when we run the program. So let's call the function create table, and you can see there we have the team Liverpool and the points 24. And that pairs together. So let's add all of the teams and all of the points. Now when we call that function and print it, we can see that all of the teams are in a dictionary with all of their points. These are key value pairs. So let's return the league table from create table function. So we will put return league. And now when we call create table, we get the table back. So a better way to see the table would be to ask to see the items of that dictionary, the key and the value together. So we can use a for loop. So here we're going to use for key and value in the table, in the items in the table dictionary, and then we're going to print that key and value. So they'll print the teams and the scores on each row. So now we have our table of teams scores. Now, rather than look at the algorithm, well, there is some code we can use to sort the table out quite simply. So if we have sorted in our for loop, we can see that the key has been sorted alphabetically. So it's not quite what we want at the moment, but if we use sorted, we can see it goes in order. Now, if we want to change that to reverse order, we can add reverse equal true. So now when we run that, that's in the reverse order. To make the ordering of values rather than keys is a bit complicated. So we're just going to copy and paste a little bit of code in here. So because we can't see it, we're just going to put that code on line 17. So you can type this code out. We're not going to explain it. We're just saying if you put that code inside the for loop after reverse is true. So we've got the sorted, we've got the reverse, and we've got this little bit of code to change the order of value rather than key. Then that puts our table in the correct order that we wish it to be. So we actually sort our table without using an algorithm, but just using this code. We have the for loop, we do sorted, reverse, and that little bit of code to make the value ordered. When we update the table, we already have the match points. So here's an example of some points of matches. So we have the teams and the amounts of points they gained from those matches. So we can put that into code using a dictionary called match points. So the key is going to be the team name again, and the value is going to be the points for that match. So if we look at update table, if we look at our scratch, we can see how we can update the two lists. So now we've only got one dictionary. So how do we update that? Well, we've got our league table. So this is the league table beforehand, and then we're going to add the scores to that, so that creates our result table, so we can update the points. And because the table is in order, we we want to sort those points with the highest first. The team with the most amount of points will be at the top of the table. So once we order that, we're going to order it by value. Then we change the order so we have the teams in the order with the most points top, going to the second most downwards. So let's have a look how we update table in Python. So we finished off looking at our table and we ordered the table after we created it. So now let's look about updating it. So we're going to create a function called updateTable. And inside that, we're going to put our points that we got from the matches. So we're not going to write the code to calculate the points. We're going to do that later. So for now, we're going to miss out a step and just create a dictionary called matchPoints that has the points that will result from that code that we'll do later, if that makes sense. So we have the function update table. These are the points that we want to update the table with. So we have the dictionary match points, we have the team name and the points. So we're going to call update table, we're going to pass it the table, and it's going to return the table back. And we need to add these points. So we've got the each match, we want to add the point of that team to the dictionary of the league. So for each key and value in the match points, so we can use a for loop. So we're going to go through each item with the key and value. In this example, K and V we're going to use. So what we need to do, we need to think, what's in the table? Well, the table key is the football team name, which is also K in the match points. The team name is the same in the match points key as the table key. So that is going to equal what it equaled before, what it was before, plus the new value, which is the points, which in this case is the V, the value in match points. Yeah. So the dictionary of the league, which is called table here, the key in it is the team, and the league points is the value, and we need that plus the value in the match points. And the match points key is the name of the team as well. So K is the team, V is the points, and the table team is the league points. So that's how we would add these match points to the table. So we can return that table. And remember, before we actually sorted the table, we ordered it. So that would give us a result. So one thing we've need to add before we put the match points in, we had to declare, we have to say that it's a dictionary first. So we say match points is a dictionary, we've added all these values to it, and then we put in those values, add them on to the values inside the table dictionary. Remember, we'll calculate the match points in different code, but this is the result of calculating those points. So if we run that, we can see the old table here. We run that, now we've got the match points added on and put in order. Thank you for watching. If you haven't already, please subscribe.